What is up, you guys? In this one, I'll show you how to use CUDA for your image processing projects. I'll show you a toy example in which you can implement convolutions on your CUDA device to speed up the entire process. But before I do so, I want to tell you that GTC is taking place on March 20 to 23, 2023.
Perfect.
The following video was recorded on NVIDIA's Orin supercomputer in Abu Dhabi and under a Creative Commons license. I'm Ahmad, Bazzi, signing in on this. So for those of you who don't know GTC, it's NVIDIA's annual GPU technology conference focusing on GPU technology and its applications. The conference brings together experts and founders like Demis Hassabis, industry leaders, visionaries and researchers like Anima, Anand Kumar, and many more. You can get to meet professionals in various fields such as artificial intelligence, high-performance computing, data science, and autonomous vehicles to showcase the latest innovations in GPU technology and share best practices. At GTC, NVIDIA and its partners demonstrate the latest advancements in hardware and software technology, including GPUs, system architectures, AI frameworks, libraries, tools, and many more. And the best part about it is that it's open to everyone, including you.
Perfect.
But I'm also hosting an awesome 4080 RTX GPU giveaway with supreme ray tracing performances thanks to the 76 dedicated ray tracing cores. If you're a gamer, designer, or even an editor, you will love it.
Perfect.
To participate in this giveaway, all you gotta do is sign up using the link below to GTC, attend Jensen's keynote on March 21st, 8 a.m. PDT or 4 p.m. CET, and some sessions of your own choice. Then screenshot me a proof that you attended the sessions directly on my email found in the description below. I will then pick a winner at random and ship him or her the GPU.
You are tuned in to another Ahmad Bazzi video.
So I'm on an NVIDIA Orin supercomputer and I'm using VS Code as my editor today. We'll start by importing numba, which is a just-in-time or JIT compiler for Python that specializes in numerical and scientific computing. It is designed to speed up numerical computations on Python. Then we import numpy, which provides a powerful array and matrix data structure and functions to manipulate and perform operations on them. NumPy is built on top of the C programming language and provides efficient algorithms for numerical operations that can handle large amounts of data. Then I'll import the exponential function from the math library, which I'll be using for my Gaussian kernel. So before I go ahead and write any image processing function or any function at all, the right way of starting is to explicitly enter a decorator related to CUDA. So CUDA, which stands for Compute Unified Device Architecture, is a parallel computing platform and programming model developed by NVIDIA for general purpose computing on GPUs. Now, to tell the function that I'll be using CUDA, I need to enter a decorator, which is done as at cuda.jit. This is a decorator in the numba library that allows developers like you to write CUDA kernels directly in Python code. So I'll start by defining the Gaussian GPU function, which implements my Gaussian kernel or filter. So for math geeks like myself, this is nothing but the Gaussian function you know. And for those into image processing, you probably know that this Gaussian kernel is a type of convolutional filter used for image smoothing and noise reduction. The Gaussian kernel is a 2D matrix of the Gaussian distribution values centered around the origin of the kernel. It is often used to blur an image by averaging the pixel values around each pixel with a weighted average, where the weights are determined by the Gaussian distribution. So here I'm defining the size and the sigma you see, which from a mathematical perspective is the standard deviation of the Gaussian distribution, but from an image processing perspective, it determines the amount of smoothing and the strength of the blur effect. In other words, a large kernel size and a large sigma value will result in a more blurred image. Note here that for CUDA, I'm using CUDA.thread IDX to implement the grid points of the Gaussian kernel, which is a built-in variable in the CUDA programming model that represents the thread index within a block of threads. Next, I'll define my sigma and kernel size. And I'll also initialize my kernel to be an all zero float 32 matrix. Note that in image processing, np.float32 is a commonly used data type. Float32 is a commonly used data type. NP is numpy, right? So it's a commonly used data type for representing images as arrays of floating point values. To be more specific, it is a numpy data type that represents a 32-bit floating point number. Next, I'll be using a special function of CUDA, which is CUDA.to_device. It is a function in the numba library that is used to copy a numpy array or a Python object to the memory of a CUDA device. In CUDA programming, data is typically stored in the device memory, which is the memory of the GPU, and the CUDA.toDevice function provides a convenient way to move data from the CPU memory to the device memory, so from the host to now device. In what follows, I'll create a convolutional function tailored for CUDA. So before I start, and as I did with the Gaussian kernel, I have to tell the JIT compiler that I'll be using this function on CUDA. So I'll type in the decorator at CUDA.JIT. I'll pass the result, which is a 2D grid, a mask with odd numbers of rows and columns, and a grayscale image.
Perfect.
Within the convolutional function, I'll start by declaring 2D coordinates of the current thread via CUDA.grid. Keep in mind that CUDA.grid is a function in the numba library that is used to compute the grid dimensions for launching a CUDA kernel.
Perfect.
So before I go into the math of the convolution, I'll just get rid of one corner case, okay, which occurs when the thread coordinates are outside of the image. In that case, I'll ignore the thread.
Perfect.
Now, to compute the results at coordinates ij, we need to use delta rows, amount of rows of the image before and after the ith row, as well as delta columns, number of columns, of the image before and after the ith column. Now, what I'm writing here is a nested loop that implements nothing other than a 2D convolution between an image and a kernel in image processing. So the 4K loop and the 4L loop are two nested loops that iterate over each element of the kernel or mask. And then the I underscore K equal I minus K plus delta rows and the J underscore L equal J minus L plus delta columns compute the indices of the image pixels that correspond to the current kernel element. I and J are the indices of the center pixel of the kernel, and delta rows and delta columns are offsets that are used to center the kernel around the pixel ij. Now this condition, if I underscore k between 0 and image rows and j underscore l between 0 and image columns, it checks if the I underscore k row index and j underscore l column index coordinates are inside the image bounds. If the coordinates are outside the image, the corresponding kernel element is skipped, just as the corner case above. And lastly, we append a value of mask k of l times image I underscore k j underscore l, which performs the convolution by multiplying the current kernel element with the corresponding image pixel and adding the result to a running sum s. By iterating over each and every element of the kernel and computing the corresponding image pixels, this code computes the weighted sum of pixel values around each pixel of the image, which is a common operation in image filtering and feature extraction. The resulting output image is often smoother or enhanced in certain features, depending on the filter used. So in this case, I'm using a Gaussian filter, and it has its own characteristics of smoothing and blurring the image.
Perfect.
Last but not least, in the convolutional function, I will store that particular pixel, S, in the ijth entry of the resulting matrix called result.
You are tuned in to another Ahmad Bazzi video.
Now, I'll import image and image ops from PIL. Now, PIL or PIL stands for Python Imaging Library. And it is a popular Python library for working with images. The image module in PIL provides a class for representing images as well as functions for reading, creating, manipulating, and saving image files in various formats. Image ops is a submodule of PIL that provides image processing operations like filtering, color manipulation, and geometric transformations.
Perfect.
Next, I'll import my image as grayscale. First, I convert the resulting grayscale image to a numpy array using the asArray function from the numpy library. Then, use grayscale to convert the opened image to grayscale using the grayscale function from the imageOps module of the PIL library. Lastly, I open an image file named ahmad.jpg using the image module from the PIL library. Then I'll use cuda.toDevice to copy the numpy array to the device memory of our CUDA-enabled GPU.
Perfect.
I'll then use a device array-like function of CUDA to create a device ND array object on the GPU that has the same shape and data type as the given NumPy array, which is the image. I'll then use our function Gaussian underscore GPU and pass it the grid dimensions. Note that one comma specifies the number of blocks in the grid, which in this case is 1. The second element, kernel size, comma kernel size, specifies the number of threads per block, which is equal to the kernel size parameter passed to the kernel. The second argument, sigma, is a scalar value that represents the standard deviation of the Gaussian distribution. The third argument, kernel size, is an integer that specifies the size of the square kernel to be computed. The fourth argument, d underscore kernel, is a device array that represents the output Gaussian kernel and is passed to the kernel by reference.
Perfect!
Now we compute the dimensions of the CUDA grid that will be used to launch a kernel. Now before we plot, we apply the convolution to our image and we measure the time taken to execute our convolution to the image.
You are watching a master at work.
Finally, we plot the image before convolution and after convolution. Now I'll be testing with different sigma values to show you the impact of the filter, of the Gaussian filter, and its convolution on our image. So that's it, guys. In this one, we simply showed you how to use CUDA kernels tailored for image processing tasks, where I showed a particular toy example on implementing convolutions, where I used the Gaussian filter, and testing out with figures and different filter parameters. So that's it for this one. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions whatsoever, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get to it as soon as possible. And don't forget to attend GTC so that you can participate in the 4080 RTX giveaway. This is Ahmad Bazzi and I'm signing out.
You are watching a master at work.
Perfect.